So when Fam smacked me with the phone, it broke on my head. And then I remixed them. I put them in a blender. I cooked them. You know what I'm saying? I plucked them out. Bing, 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 bing. His mans and them wolf packs me. So they jumps me.
What it do? Sitting with the crew. I been get some food. I see you looking like you do. Had to make a move, make a move. Tell us got a glow. And a Jimmy Jules. Break the rules. No, you're not a fool. But I'm in the mood.
Explain to the people. What was Rikers Island like in the 90s? Because from everything I've seen and heard, the 90s in Rikers Island was probably the most dangerous decade that Rikers Island ever seen, you know, with the influx of the blood stuff and all that other stuff going on. What was it like? What was it like? And what was it like for you, like from what you seen?
Okay, so, you know, in 95, I already was active in the streets. So in my mind, you know, I'm thinking I'm one of the toughest young niggas ever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At this point. But when I got locked up for the robberies in 95, I already was Muslim because I got aunts and uncles and all that that's Muslim. So I'm third generation Muslim for my family. I got aunts and uncles and a grand uncle. My grandmother, one of her brothers was Muslim. And my aunts and uncles and was Muslim, and then it's me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm third generation Muslim, but I used to be under a guy named Malachi Z. York. I took my Shahada under his community back in 1990.
I heard of that, brother. Okay.
Yeah, I took my Shahada under his community before they left and went down south, and they switched their name to the Nuwabian Nation of the Moors. But when they went from the Ansar Allah community, they went to the Holy Tabernacle, and then they went to the Nuwabian Nation of the Moors. Now they just call themselves the Nuwabians. But long story short, so I already was Muslim before I went to jail. So when I get locked up in 95, they send me the first house I land in is Mod 1. So when I land in Mod 1, I don't really know the ropes, but I bumps into a dude I went to junior high school with named Prince. They called Prince Bad Boy. His blood name was Bad Boy. So when I came in, he like, oh shit, you know, he called me my government name. He like, oh shit, my guy, bro. So I'm like, yo, what's good? He like, ain't nothing, man. You know, I got a phone, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, you got a phone? He like, yeah, man. He like, yo, they call me Bad Boy in here. He like, yo, I'm blood. I'm like, you blood? Like, what you mean, like California? He like, yeah, I'm blood. So it baffled me. But he had a phone, everything was valid. So he wound up going to population first because Mar 1 is Ori. That's like
intake.
Like orientation. Yeah, it's like intake, like an orientation kind of dorm. So he went to population first. After he left, niggas tried to play with me in the dorm. Like it was my time to get on the phone. I was house gang too. I didn't know what the fuck that shit was. He was like, you'll get the house gang job. You can clean the dorm and you'll get paid for it. So I had joint house gang. So when he went to regular population, it was my time to get on the phone. It was like 7 o'clock at the phone. At this time, the phones is rocking straight through. Prime time started at 6 o'clock. So it was from 6 o'clock to click, niggas had slot time. So my slot time was 7 to 8. So when it was my time to get on the phone one day, it was a 5% dude on the phone named Bright, guard body nigga named Bright. He was from Brooklyn to Queens. So I'm like, yo, bro, I'm about to get on the phone. He like, all right, yeah, I got you. But I noticed like 5-10 minutes passed, he ain't get off the phone. I'm like, yo, bro, what the you doing? Why I gotta get on the phone? The nigga tried to smack me with the phone.
Oh,
so when
man.
He smacked me, he did smack me with the phone. Like he popped on me, he smacked me with the phone, but the phone like broke on my head. So to outside niggas looking in, it looked like, oh, he hit him super hard. He broke the phone on his head. But really, that shit is plastic. It didn't really do nothing to me. And then I grew up in the streets. Like, when I grew up as a kid, niggas got punched in the mouth every day. We fought, scraped our knees.
Facts. Or you not coming outside.
Exactly. You can't even come outside unless you going to get it in. So, you know, I already was trained for all this thumping shit anyway. So when Fam smacked me with the phone, it broke on my head. And then I remixed them. I put them in a blender. I cooked them. You know what I'm saying? I plucked them out. Bing, 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 bing. His mans and them wolf packs me. So they jumps me. Bing, 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 bing. Long story short, I'm going to be going to the mess hall like later on that day. My man see like the lump on my head. He like, yo, what happened? I said, yeah, niggas jumped me over the phone. He like, oh, when y'all niggas come to population, it's lit for y'all. Boo boo, when y'all come to population. So I wound up going to population with them niggas. Like, we all went to population in the same day. They sent me to Mar Far Lower, right? And they sent some of them niggas to Mar too. When they sent them to Mar too, my man Master was at rest in peace from Webster. He already was in Mar too. And my man Smurf, Grimy Smurf. It used to be a gang on Webster Avenue called the Smurf Mob. It was Grimy Smurf, Shiesty Smurf. So my man Grimy Smurf was in Mar too. So when them niggas went to Mar too, they got washed up. You know what I'm saying? Because it was mad Bronx niggas heavy in the four building at this time.